Hi, after a marathon wait, the elections are over across the country. One of the India's greatest captains and one who changed the face of Indian cricket, plagued by match fixing controversies, Sourav Ganguly at the helm of affairs. I think the entire cricketing fraternity should consider itself to be very, very lucky. Coming down the line, Roger Binney being elected as the president of Karnataka State Cricket Association and Santosh Menon being elected as the secretary of KSCA. I'm sure they are poised to do well for the game. Coming to Mysore scenario, we have Sudhakar Rai sir, who has been elected as the convener of Mysore cricket, and we have Hari Krishna sir, who has played a lot of cricket, who is still playing cricket and who is still picking up a lot of wickets, assumes the charge as the chairman. The first thing to understand and accept is that Mysore cricket needs an uplift. I have been going through this course of the zonals, under 14, under 16, under 19. To be very, very honest, they let the Mysore cricket down. I met G.V. Ravi a couple of days back and we were discussing the era of Sushant, Prajwal Raj, Pante, Aple. See, I take this leverage of calling them by their nicknames because that is how the cricketing fraternity knows them. Then we have Saptagirish, we have G.V. Ravi himself, we have Bharti Sutha, Udgalli Mahesh, we have M.V. Satish, Lodde Kiran, and we have Srinivas Prasad and the like. They simply dominated the Mysore cricket for over the years, be it in zonal matches or be it in university matches. They were the teams like the West Indies of 1980s or the Australians of 2000s or the Indian cricket team at present. They were the undisputed kings on the cricket ground. Thereon, the quality of cricket slowly but surely started to diminish. Of course, there are few stray of incidents like Nikhin Jos, Vishnu Priya, and now M. Venkatesh, who is doing really good for the game. See, you can expect this in a place like Mysore where 1000 odd players actually play the game and one off is bound to blossom. Running league matches and finishing it on time and keeping the system clean from vested interests and irregularities in selection process is of course of paramount importance. But the larger issue is, can we develop players, at least 7-8 players in each age category so that they dominate the cricket in Karnataka for the next 5-6 years? Can we give more emphasis for girls cricket? Can we train them throughout the year? Can we produce yet another Mithali Raj or Veda Krishnamurthy from Mysore? Well, if the previous administration was magnificent, we hope this administration to be majestic. I wish you all the best.